Bueno, pues en esta ocasión tengo la suerte y el privilegio de entrevistar a la primera participante baterista mujer que viene al Drum Fest de Tam Tam, Cherise O'Shea. Welcome to Sevilla. How are you? So
Hello.
good to have you here.
Thanks for
I will
having
say
me.
you are the first woman. No, actually, you are the second. I'm sorry. We had
Oh, I'm the
Cindy
second.
Blackman. No. Cindy
Oh.
Blackman was here once.
Oh, okay. That's okay
That's
then.
right.
That's okay. Okay, I'm the second. That's
Well,
good.
no, you're the second woman
Second
drummer, which
woman.
is something that is not that usual. I mean, we find this it's a men's world, kind, sort to speak. And I was telling you about this group I created with three drummers, Manuela, Isa, Dori, and they have so many concerns about this world they have to face when they get on the stage, being a woman playing a drum set, and how people will look at them with, uncertainty, like, you're going to be drumming? And then even if they like, they say, wow, that wasn't that bad being a woman. I mean, how do you feel about that? How do you deal with all
Well,
that
unfortunately,
stupid?
yeah, that does happen, unfortunately. You know, there are a lot of prejudices in this world, racism, sexism, and they exist. But for me, I think that the history of drumming is male dominated. So being a female drummer, you are up against people's preconceptions of what female drummers are capable of. So because of this means you do have to work doubly as hard. You have to keep proving yourself. And for me, I've learned to ignore people's misconceptions, and I use it as a way, as a motivation to work harder and become a better musician. Because to me, music has no gender.
Of course
And to
not.
me, like, I see myself as a drummer, not as a girl drummer.
You are a
So
drummer. The
exactly,
gender
full
is another
stop.
thing. Full
Exactly,
stop.
exactly. So me being a girl has nothing to do with my actual playing. Because music, as I said, has no gender. So, yeah, you just learn to ignore it basically, and you just have to kind of get on with it, you know. But it can be tough. It can be really tough. But I would just say to any girls that are picking up the drumsticks, to play, just play and enjoy it, and forget what they say, and just really, just yeah, go for it. If you really enjoy something, you want to do it, then do it. That's my advice.
Absolutely. That's wonderful. You've been touring all over with Mika, with Bryan Ferry. I mean, you've been on big venues, big arenas, doing concerts. How do you face those type of settings where you have to play in front of so many people?
Well, and something that I actually talk about in my clinic, which I'm doing tomorrow, I talk about stage nerves and how I dealt with my stage nerves. There's a few different things that I like to do. First of all, like, I actually have a routine that I do before every gig. So what I do is I try and relax first and foremost. I try and chill out and get in the zone, try and eat some good food and just chill out.
And mentally.
Mentally, yeah, try and mentally prepare and get in the zone. Secondly, I like to warm up. So I make sure that I'm warm. So when I go onto stage, I'm ready to play. My muscles are warm, you know, I'm feeling good. And the last thing I do is I use visualization. So I actually, and this is just before I go on stage, I picture myself playing the first song in the set, but really, really well, in the best way possible. So the reason I do that is so I'm focusing on the best outcome, which means it's more likely to happen. So already I'm focusing my energy on playing really well and projecting that image into my head. So therefore, I go on stage. Yeah, I go on stage. Hopefully, I play, you know, nearly as good. And if I play even half as good, then that is fine. You know, that's great. That works. So yeah, I have a few different tactics. Yeah, to deal with stage nerves.
Technique-wise, do you prepare yourself in the warm-up with certain exercises you consider good for that? What type of exercise you do?
Well, I actually use a book called Stick Control, which is fantastic by George Stone. It's an old book. And I use that. I pick a page from that book and I do some exercises. So I'll do single strokes, double strokes, rolls, triplets, you know, paradiddles. I'll sit there for 20 minutes on a pad or actually on a pillow. Pillows are really good for warming up on because they haven't got any rebound. So it really warms you up very, very quickly. So I like to get a pillow as well. But yeah, I'll do a pad or a pillow. And yeah, I'll do 20 minutes of just, you know, very simple exercises. Just anything you can do to get your hands moving, you know, just even sitting there, just, you know, doing eights on each hand, you know, and then 16s. Just, yeah, get your hands moving and get your muscles warm.
You got any formal training? I mean, you read music, you've been
Yes, well,
working on your craft.
Yeah, well, I'm constantly working on my ability. Since the age of 12, I've had drum lessons, and I'm still studying to this day. I still have a drum teacher. Because to me, you can always learn more. There's always, you know, more to learn. And that's how you gain your confidence. You know, like, and for me playing these big arenas, I gain my confidence because I'm prepared. I've been learning, you know, really, you know, working on my ability. And yeah, so I do learn. And yeah, mm-hmm. I love it. And, you know, and that's the thing. Yeah, definitely.
We opened this year the section in Facebook for questions from the audience who are going to be here tomorrow. And some of them ask about what type of exercise would you recommend before getting on stage or for a daily routine? Is there a specific thing you will recommend?
Yeah, I would recommend getting stick control.
Stick control.
Getting the book Stick Control. It just is fantastic. Like, I've had the book my whole life, my whole drumming life, and I'm only about a third of the way through the book. It has loads of different stickings, yeah. Exercises, and I pick, you know. So today I'm going to do page 13. Uh-huh. I pick and then sit there and, you know, do them. And that's what I would suggest. You know, that is, yeah.
It's a wonderful suggestion.
It works for me, so.
Very, very good.
Yeah.
And how about what kind of music you enjoy playing? I mean, you've done pop, rock music kind of.
Yeah.
But is there any specific thing you enjoy most?
Well, to be honest, I just love playing good music in whatever form that's in. I like, you know, I like funk, I like jazz. I like soul, I like rock, I like pop. I have a very wide range of, you know, musical styles that I listen to. And my mum and dad were very influential in my musical taste growing up. They were always playing music in the house. They're mm-hmm. big music lovers. My dad was, really into soul and jazz and funk and hip hop. My mum was kind of into Van Morrison and the Beatles, Led Zeppelin. Mm-hmm. So I had a real mix of music. So for me, there's just two types of music. There's good and there's bad.
Good and bad, yeah.
And I like playing good music. It's simple as that, you know. That's my criteria.
I hear you. Any musicians in the family?
No, I am the first musician in my whole family.
Exciting.
Yeah, my dad is actually an actor. He does some acting. So, mm-hmm. yeah, there's a link there. He's in the entertainment industry. So there's a link, yeah, between me being a musician.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And what is a regular day in your life, and a normal day in your life back in
a
England?
A normal day?
Yeah, do you have any normal days?
I don't think I do have any normal days, but I think that's what I like about being a drummer, is that every day is different. Every gig is different. No matter what, like, you know, like, say I'm going on tour, every night is different. Even if you're playing the same venue,
yeah.
The set's different, the crowd's different. What you play is different, how you feel is different. So I don't really have a normal day, if that answered your question.
And regarding technique, is there any specific way you hold the drumsticks or use the pedals? I mean, any advice on that, Charisse?
Yeah, well, for me, because of my size, and this has nothing to do with the fact that I'm a girl, but because of my size, I'm quite small. So people are always shocked when they see me. They always say, you know, you have such tiny hands, how do you make such noise? So I've had to really work on my technique, make sure I'm playing in the correct way. So I use common grip, match grip. And yeah, I sort of play out of the drum, you know, let all the shock come out of the drum, so play out of everything. But yeah, just my aim is to try and play really relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I do have to have good techniques. Unfortunately, I don't have that upper body strength that somebody bigger than me might have. So I've had to work on my technique to make sure that I can get that volume and that power mm-hmm. that is required for certain music. But if I need to play lighter, then I have the technique for that as well. So technique, I think, is very important. And for me, technique is having the right tools in your toolbox. So it's a way of allowing you to do what you want to do, you know. So yeah, technique's very, very important, I'd say, yeah.
One thing Manuela asked me on this group we made was about being beautiful on stage.
Yeah.
I mean, so many prejudices about that. And why so? I mean, how do you face that, those kind of things?
Well,
just get even prettier.
Yeah, I just get even prettier. I just think I'm going to get more sparkly. I'm going to do more. For me, I think it's a shame that that is the case. You know, that people view that, you know, like makeup and girls as sort of lesser than a bloke going on stage doing nothing. You know, like, there's nothing wrong with looking pretty on the drums. Why not? You know, for me, it's all about the music and about the person. And if the musician can do the job, it's not about whether they're, you know, a female or a male. But unfortunately, sometimes it is that case. But again, just get on with it. Just put it on, put the makeup on, put more on. That's what I say.
Forgive them. How about being here in Spain? How many times have you been here before?
I've been in Spain quite a lot, actually. I've done a lot of touring here. Uh-huh. With Mika. So I was with Mika for 7 years. Wow. So we did a lot of touring and we did a lot in Spain. Uh-huh. So yeah, mainly Madrid, Barcelona, Valencia. This is my first time in Seville. I love it here.
How do you like
it? It's so beautiful. It's a beautiful place.
You have
so
nice weather.
You're very lucky. I'm very jealous. I live in London. So.
I hear you.
But no, Spain's lovely. I love Spain. Uh-huh. Yeah, I love it.
That's wonderful. And what do you think about these kind of festivals, the Drum Fest, Tam Tam Drum Fest?
I think they're brilliant. I think there should be more drum festivals, you know, for drummers. Because I think it's a really good place for drummers to come and learn. As well, you know, you can come and but you can always learn something by watching another drummer. Mm-hmm. So if you're a drummer coming to this as a young drummer, it's fantastic. You come and you watch all these guys and you pick up different things. You can go and talk to other drummers. There's a real, you know, sense of community. For me growing up, there was only the London Drum Show, so it was one drum show once a year, you know, but now there's so many more, and I think it's fantastic. I think we need more. Yeah,
isn't it? It's great. They do a wonderful effort and tam. They're excellent. We have one student in my academy, Lucia. She's only 9 or 10 years old, and she's reading music, playing so well.
Fantastic.
I mean, she's a great drummer. I just wanted to mention she'll be here tomorrow to see you and to see all the great drummers are going to be here.
Well, I'd love to meet her. I mean, for me, like, I actually did do my grades in music. Mm-hmm. I studied. So I did. I passed my grade 8 at age 15. So I did study drums, and as I said, I had lessons from age 12. And I think that really, doing the grades gave me a really good foundation for drumming. So I had to learn all the rudiments. I learned to read drum music, play pieces, and yeah, it's a good foundation. So I would definitely recommend any young drummers to, yeah, study, get a teacher. If you can do grades, you know, then
the grades from Rock School or Brazzam?
No, this was from the Guildhall School of Music, which is in London.
Yeah.
So it's a kind of mixed bag. It's kind of, a mixed.
That's excellent.
Mixed, yeah.
What are you going to be doing tomorrow? What are you going to be playing? What are you?
Well,
you got your endorsers.
Yes,
supporting you.
Yes, I've got fantastic endorsers. Yes. My drums are Tama drums, which sound lovely. I play Zildjian cymbals. And I play Vic Firth and Remo and Yamaha Electronics. And yes, no, tomorrow it's going to be a mixed bag of music. I'm going to play some of the songs from the artists that I've worked with. So you'll hear some Mika, some Brian Ferry, some Paloma Faith. So I think just wait and see. You'll see tomorrow. It's going to be interesting, at least.
And what other projects are you involved at this moment back in England or anywhere else?
Yeah, at the moment, I am working with some British singers. I'm playing with a singer called Alicia Dixon, who is a judge on Britain's Got Talent. Mm-hmm. So I've been working with her. I'm working with an up-and-coming singer called Baby Soul, who works with Paloma Faith as well. I've just launched my new website, which is, come out, which is, cherise.com, which is really exciting. I'm just doing lots of gigs and doing more clinics as well, a bit of teaching. So yeah, keeping busy.
So you do teach as well?
Yeah, I teach on the side as well. Uh-huh. Yeah, because I'm really...
And you use a small drum set. I mean, small, sort to speak about pieces. I mean, you only have one tom and then the floor tone. That's about it. That's all
I love playing simply. Yeah, like I love a simple setup. Because I think you have to be more creative when you have less to play on. That makes sense. I think you've got to think more outside of the box. And I like having less to sort of, you know, try and get different sounds and different, you know, timbres out of the drums. I really enjoy just simplicity. And music that I play, pop music, is simple, you know. And to make simple sound great is, that's the key.
That's about what you need.
Exactly. Yeah. That's what we're all aiming for. So for me, I just love playing with a simple setup. I mean, when I was touring with Mika, I did have a slightly bigger setup because we were playing arenas, we're doing these big shows. So I had two floor toms, I had a gong drum, I had timbales, I had cowbells. So I had quite a big setup there, two snares.
Cans to play on?
Yeah, yes, I did.
I googled you and I saw those solos with Mika in a big can.
Yeah, we had trash cans.
Trash cans.
We used to do like a yeah, like a big duo, yeah, a big drum battle.
So fun.
Sometimes it's nice, yeah, sometimes it's good to have a bigger setup and it can sort of, you know, add to what you're doing. But generally my setup is pretty simple.
I love the way you laid down the backbeat on your, on the snare. I mean, it's like you, it leaves this space so nice. I mean, I saw a little bit of your sound check.
Oh,
and I really love
much.
It. I mean, it was like grooving so much in the pocket. I mean,
it's, thank you very much.
That was wonderful.
Thank you.
That was wonderful. How do you develop that? I mean, how do you think about that space between notes?
Again, that is a lot of, it's taken me a lot of time to work on that. But the two things that for me that are key to getting that feel and that groove are timing and feel. So I spent a lot of time working on my timing. I spent a lot of time with the metronome.
With the metronome.
Yeah, like hours, you know, playing, you know, playing on different parts of the beat, you know, playing different time signatures with the click, playing around with the click and getting really comfortable with the click. Because most of the time when you're, you know, working as a session drummer, you are playing to a click. If you're recording in the studio, you're playing to a click. If you're playing live with a band, you might have backing tracks and that'll be to a click. So timing is one thing. And then feel. Feel is a very strange thing because you can't really teach somebody feel. But what you can do is you can listen to the masters. That's how you kind of learn. And that's what I did. I listened to all the greats, you know, James Gadson with Bill Withers, Steve Gadd, Jeff Beccaro. Listen to those guys and try and copy them, you know, emulate them and try and study why what they're playing sounds so good. Try and identify what makes their feel so good. Is their bass drum slightly quieter? Is it late? Is it, you know, is the snares? Is it, you know, yeah, really studying feel. So those two things, for me, are very important to having a nice groove.
I loved it. I mean, your snare was a little bit behind, but so much in the place. It was fantastic. I mean, it really
was
groovy. It was very, very groovy.
Oh, thank you very much.
So, you know that we got a sold out room in three or four days. I mean, everyone is looking forward to see you. All the female drummers we got here are really excited.
Oh, brilliant. I'm excited. I'm excited to be here. I mean, it's such a great festival.
It is.
And I can't wait to play. And I can't wait to meet some of the female drummers and, you know, just show that, you know, girls can do it too.
Absolutely.
And, you know,
no doubt about
it. Yeah, does it make a difference what sex you are?
Yeah,
it doesn't matter.
Of course not. We definitely have to erase that from
I think we will within
time. Stand, little by little.
Yeah, little by little. Yeah, we're moving in the right direction. I mean, like, it is becoming, like, the number of female drummers that are successful is growing.
Terry Lynn Carrington.
Yeah.
I met her in the States. Hannah Ford.
Hannah Ford, of course. Yeah.
Cindy Blackman, we mentioned
Cindy
before.
Blackman.
You.
Thank you.
Sheila E.
Yeah.
Talking about being glimmering on stage. I mean,
yeah. There's Daisy Palmer from the UK who played with Goldfrapp. Now plays with, what's her name? That's really bad. She plays with, I can't remember her name, let's forget that one. Emily Dolan Davies.
I saw you in an interview with her.
Yeah, who played with The Darkness, and also with Brian Ferry. Me and her grew up playing drums together, actually. We both started playing drums on the same day at school.
Wow.
So we both started playing drums at school. So, there's lots of, it's becoming more widely accepted and more common for girls to play drums. Which is fantastic. So we are moving in the right direction, for sure.
That's wonderful. It's great having you here. I want to thank you, Charisse.
Oh,
thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I'm looking forward to see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I look forward to playing.
Thank you.